Hey guys, welcome to OsChannel. So if you have ever used the zip function in Python, you know exactly how convenient it is to combine two iterators. Let's follow this example of two lists where we combine them using the zip function, and then we can either loop through these two lists simultaneously or we can easily convert this into a dictionary. But did you know that if you try to combine two iterators of different length, then you can potentially end up losing your data without even noticing it? This is exactly the problem Python 3.10 fixes by introducing the strict boolean for the zip function. So if you set the strict boolean to true, the zip function will automatically throw an error. And in this class, I am going to show you one of the ways to catch that error and process the iterators without losing your data. Okay, so I'm going to continue with the same example, and I hope you guys noticed that this alphabet E is missing from this output of zip. So in order to fix this, what we can do, I'll just let this print remain here and let's do a dzip equal to and copy this. And from here, Python 3.10 allows us to add this boolean called strict equal to true. And now let's print dzip. And what this will do is basically it will check if the length of both these lists or iterators are same, else throw an error. So let's execute this, and you can see that we have now received an error saying that argument 2 is shorter than argument 1, which is the list 2 is shorter than the list 1. And so now we are at least avoiding silent data loss. So in order to actually not lose the data and still process this, we can actually put this inside a try catch block, except, and let's do a value error, colon. So there is a zip longest function that is provided by itertools that we can use. So we do from itertools import zip underscore longest. And we can actually use this in a similar fashion. Zip longest, and then pass on list 1 and list 2. And the best part about zip longest is you can actually provide a fill value. For now, let's give it none, but you can pass on any data. And now, if we try to execute this, let's try it. So now you can see basically it returns the alphabet E as well. So this is the output from the first print statement, and this is from the second one. And we see basically E colon none because of this zip longest. So some might argue, why not directly use zip longest? And my answer to this question is zip is comparatively much faster compared to zip longest, and I did some profiling to show you guys, and you can see a 0.5 second difference, which is not large, but this goes on increasing if the size of the iterators passed onto the zip or the zip longest function increases. So that's all for this video, guys. If you liked my video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel to support my videos. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.